The question this week is, developer or engineer?
So I'm going to lean with developer and maybe a little bit of engineer.
Yes, and because the thing is, you know, these engineers are they are always been out there to create and innovate, right? And today is their opportunity in networking to actually develop and build new capabilities. Their businesses are relying on them to create wholly new innovations, and without them, the business will not be able to move at the speed of digital.
How about both?
I think to me, developer just rings a little bit clearer for the creativity that everybody brings into the work that they're doing here.
So developers today are our engineers. If you're an engineer, you need to become, at least have a development frame of mind.
Engineer, because when you're engineering, you're developing as well, amongst other things too.
It's about being this hybrid engineer where you've got the skills of your domain understanding of your infrastructure, but then taking the best practices, the tool sets, the skill sets from a developer and really combining them into that hybrid engineer, the best of both worlds.
Developer, all the way.
For me, it is developer. Yeah, because what is happening is with DevNet's recent certification announcement, you know, there's a convergence of software developers and networking engineers, right? So the certifications are basically aimed at catering to both these personas. So essentially with networking infrastructure being more and more programmable, a lot of the pure play software developers who are line of business type people are now seeing the network as yet another software play.
You can be a developer without being an engineer. You can be an engineer without being a developer. But being one without the other is really, really difficult to be successful. You can develop code, but without having that engineering discipline, you might not actually develop something that is sustainable and operable. And if you're an engineer and you can design systems, but you're not able to actually implement them in a manner that you can operate and maintain, then you're really lacking on a skill set that's important. So I would say that it's a little bit of both.
It's really hard to be an engineer today without being, like I said, a software power user. And it's hard to be a developer without having some kind of understanding of how the network operates and some of the engineering functions.
I like engineer because I feel like it's more inclusive because it allows you to expand not just to people who write code every day as a developer, but to people who approach every problem with an engineering mindset. So maybe you have a marketing problem or a problem in HR or a problem in, I don't know, any aspect of your life, and you want to think of it quantitatively and algorithmically, then you're an engineer. And maybe you become a developer by actually using code to solve that problem.
In the industry with networks and programmability, it's fantastic to have the ability to program that network, but unless you actually understand the engineering behind what you want that network to do, and probably more importantly, why, you're not going to end up with a really good outcome. So for me, I think we need the two worlds of developer and engineer to come together.
It has to be both. It has to be both. I have to go back to my college days. My major is electrical engineering and computer science.
Wow.
They were together, right? So that mixture of engineering skills together with software skills is super important. I hope that we bring that back to our industry, because the networking industry has to be networking skills and software skills. So let's do it.
In my mind, when I think of an engineer, it's taking something and building something that's already been predefined. As a developer, think about it. It's like it's starting from like ground zero and putting that creative process into it, designing something, and then eventually building and delivering something. So definitely developer.
I started off my life as doing computers and office automation. Then I did software, and then I went into networking, and then I did software because I worked out you couldn't really do networking without software. So I think both. I think there's two tracks, network engineer, software engineer, and in the middle you got that DevOps, net DevOps, etc. piece that sits in the middle. And I think that's the direction that a lot of the engineers that we see now need to step into, that because the world that we live in today is just too complicated. From a networking perspective, it's too complicated to do it using CLI and other tools. You've got to know how to automate, and you've got to know how to do that. In order to do that, you need to be a little bit of software development, but in order to know what you're trying to do, you also need to know your domain expertise, whether it's networking or data center. So the combination of the two.
And the way technology is evolving,
you're going to have a little bit of both or a lot of either one.
You need the engineer, you need the developer, and they complement each other to make the network work.
DevEng.
DevEng?
The combination of the two, merging the two together.
Well, we're in the right place for that, and thank you so much for being with us every single year.
Pleasure. Thanks very much.